Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy.
In this lecture, we'll understand NAND SR latch. Latch is the basic storage element and it can hold one bit of data. So SR latch can be classified as NOR latch and NAND latch. In this lecture, we'll understand NAND SR latch. This is the logic diagram for NAND SR latch. So now, before going to understand this operation of NAND SR latch, first let us understand the truth table of NAND gate. This is the truth table for NAND gate. So if we observe this truth table, so we identify that if any one of the input is 0, output is 1. So if both the inputs are 1, output is 0. Using this logic, we'll understand the operation of NAND SR latch. Now let us see the working of NAND SR latch. Now let us consider if S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. So we will check what happens to the output when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. So S is 0 here, R is 1. We know if any one of the input is 0, output will be 1. So Q will be equal to 1. So this 1 will appear here. So 1, 1, output is 0. So Q bar will be equal to 0. So we got Q as 1 and Q bar as 0. So Q will be equal to 1 and Q bar will be equal to 0. So this is the state of output we got when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. Now we'll make S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. So we'll see what happens to the output. So S is made as 1, R is 1. So the previous output Q was 1. So this 1 will appear here. So 1, 1, output is 0. So Q bar will remain 0. So this 0 will appear here. So 1, 0, output is 1. So if we make S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, output remain same. Q will be equal to 1 and Q bar will be equal to 0. That's why we'll call this state as memory state. Now let us take the second case where S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. So S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. From this truth table, if any one of the input is 0, output will be 1. Since R is equal to 0, irrespective of what we get at this input, Q bar will be equal to 1. So this 1 will appear here. So 1, 1, that will make Q as 0. So we got this state, Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 1. This is the output when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. Now let us make S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. So we have made S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. So previous output of Q was 0. So this 0 will appear here. So 0, 1, output will be 1. So Q bar will get 1. So this 1 will appear here. So this 1, 1 will make Q as 0. So 1, 1, output is 0. So we will get Q as 0. So we got the same output when we make S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. So Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 1. So this state is known as memory state. Now let us take the third condition where S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0. For S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, we know the condition. If any one of the input is 0, output will be 1. Since R is equal to 0, Q bar will be equal to 1. So this 1 will appear here. So 0, 1, again output Q will be equal to 1. So here we got the condition where Q is equal to 1 and Q bar is equal to 1. So this condition is not valid because Q bar is complement of Q. So if Q is 1, Q bar should be 0. So this condition is not satisfied. So we'll call this state where S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0 as invalid state. Now let us write the truth table for NAND SR latch. We'll write S, R, Q and Q bar is the output. So four combinations, 00, 01, 10, 11. So when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, this state is invalid state. And when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, this state is memory state. When S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, Q is equal to 1 and Q bar is equal to 0. And when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, Q is 0 and Q bar is 1. So this is the truth table for NAND SR latch. Hope you have understood this topic. Thank you.